Welcome. I'm so glad you're here for today's podcast. I'm Gayla Scrivener, your host. You know, a few weeks ago, I made a bold move and made the decision to change the name of my podcast. I even was so bold to announce it on episode 46. Now, you'll notice that the title, Accomplish More Podcast, is still on all the promos as of today's release. I did drop the normal intro bit for the past few weeks, and today isn't any different. No intro blurb. Why? Well, here's the honest to goodness truth. Two things. First, I was so gung-ho on changing the name of the podcast because I shifted a bit in messaging. Sure, I believe that we all as individuals and business owners should like to accomplish more, but truly, my passion is achieving and helping others achieve a work-from-anywhere lifestyle. Or simply a lifestyle where you can work on your own terms, create a business using your talents, and not have to ask permission to be gone from work. If you feel like moving, you don't have to feel like you completely are starting over to find a new job. Also, you have unlimited earning potential. So, I thought it would be good to change the name of the podcast from Accomplish More to a name that's something different and try to encompass the direction I'm going. I tossed around several names and joked to say that just calling it The Gayla Scrivener Show. And at first, I was motivated to just go with the self-titled podcast. And so that leads me to the second reason for delaying the name change. Holy cow, my schedule is full. There is work that needs to be done in changing a podcast's name. There are many details to attend to. Not a big deal in the grand scheme of things. That's what I like. I like detail work. That's not what scares me. That's not, you know, that's what my team and I do at Scrivener Solutions for our clients. It's the detail work. But here's the thing. I made the declaration of the change and then shifted my priorities toward other things. Now, it's not an excuse, just a reality of what happens. But as time passed, though, I began to have doubts and second-guessed myself. Thoughts like, who am I to have a self-titled podcast? I'm not well-known. But you know what? That is perfectly okay. I may not be well-known yet, but I would love for you to get to know me and hope to inspire you to make a change and build a small business, creating the lifestyle you desire. My desired lifestyle happens to be a work-from-anywhere lifestyle. Yours may look a little different, but you can do it. Now, next week, you'll see the changes implemented. I'm doing the detail work. I think it will be perfect timing because next week will mark my 50th podcast episode. That will be a cool new beginning of the Gayla Scrivener Show. Now, all of this leads up to why I titled today's episode the way I did. Feel like Stretch Armstrong and pulled to the limit? Okay, I'm sure I'm dating myself, but do you remember Stretch Armstrong? If you know exactly what I'm talking about, I'm so glad you do. If not, well, I feel really old. But be that as it may, if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about, or should I say who I'm talking about and who Stretch Armstrong is, well, it's a toy of a muscle man that you can stretch his arms and legs to, I think, at least 4 times their normal limit or their normal size. Now, my brother had one, and we would play tug-of-war with him. It's kind of fun. I don't know why we found it entertaining, but we did. And I'm pretty sure many kids found it entertaining because they still sell them. even many versions. I got to thinking the other day, with everything that I have to do, and I felt like I was Stretch Armstrong, just stretched to the limit. Stretched thin and feeling unsure of what direction to go first or what should my priority be. Being stretched in this way is not a bad thing. It just happens as we venture into doing new things. In podcast 45, I talked about achieving more work freedom and the fact that it is very possible. Achieving this freedom doesn't mean it happens overnight, and it doesn't mean it's not without its work. How it happens is little things done over time, and you begin new and little habits, and you build on those habits, and soon enough you'll be creating a business using your talents and your experience to help others. Therefore, you're creating the lifestyle you want. Now, sometimes we get comfortable where we're at. We may feel stuck in a dead-end job, or we're stuck in a job with a terrible work environment, but we stay. I get it. I've been there. Sometimes there are very good reasons, and the timing has to be right to leave a situation. For example, I stayed at a job that I didn't particularly love because I wanted to stay there until I was vested so that when I did leave, I could take my full retirement. You know, because the company matched funds up until I think that at that time I needed to stay with the company 7 years. So I found good things about the job and continued learning. But I didn't want to act hastily because even though I wanted to leave, I could tough it out for another year or so. During that time, I explored options and possibilities, but I strategically stayed in that position. There was a reason. Now, my cousin is a teacher and has been teaching for many, many years, since right out of college. She'd like to stop teaching. She wants to do something else. But she only has 5 more years before she receives a great retirement plan. You know, and she'll be retiring young. I mean, I think she'll be almost 50. That is super young to be retired. And it makes financial sense to just stay put for now. But since she knows she wants to do something totally different when she retires, then why not start now with a business on the side? Create a following and have something going on so that when the time comes for that retirement celebration, she has something else to go into and something that she really loves. But what if you are frustrated and have absolutely no idea what you'd like to do instead? Sometimes our mindset gets stuck there. We go to this dead-end job or this bad work environment, and you don't know what else to do. I get that. I've been there. That mindset wasn't there. I didn't know. I was in the same industry for 20 years. What the heck am I going to do? But I wish I had this magic wand and help you tell you what to do. My magic wand would just say, I'd tell you to create a business where you would use online tools to market what your experience is and what you can offer other folks, and you build a following. You build a following so that you attract your perfect client. And there's bumps along the way. There's things to experience. Sometimes you kind of have to find yourself to know what you really want to do. And you help others using your talents that you already have. And you may be surprised of how your newfound business, your newfound career may jaunt off of what maybe you went to school for. Teaching you how to do this is what I'd like to help you with. But my magic wand can't help you with finding what you are passionate about. That's up to you. You need to really kind of search deep to see what new thing you want to try, what you're going to stick your neck out, and figure out what would make you happy. And it has to come from inside of you. Now, for me, I don't want to sell another company's product or have some home parties to sell stuff. that's not like me. That doesn't fit with what I like to do. I live in a small space and I love to travel. So having these home parties to sell stuff just doesn't fit with my lifestyle. But it may be something that you are passionate about. There may be a product out there that you like to sell, but that's not mine. But just use your talents and use what you already know, and you can help other people. Now, there is risk involved in breaking out of what you normally do, but we must start stretching yourself. Even if you are going to a job that you're miserable in and you're just not happy, you might find yourself staying there because you're apprehensive in stretching yourself to do something new. Anytime we start something new, we end up stretching our limits. That's how we achieve our goals, by stretching ourselves. It doesn't matter if it's how you're starting something new for marketing your business, like maybe starting a blog or a podcast or even a newsletter. You start that, but you've got to have discipline and consistency and learn from it. That is how you start that process. But you could also strive for losing weight by eating differently, and that takes consistency and small steps and shifting for a lifestyle change. Or you want to, well, I don't know. Maybe you want to take a test to become an amateur radio operator, and that would stretch yourself to achieve a goal. Now, I threw that last thing about ham radio just for fun. You know, my husband Robert is what I call, well, in our family call, a ham evangelist, and is always after me to take the technician test. And I'm not interested. At least, I'm not interested for the moment. Who knows when I'll be ready to stretch myself and enter into his ham evangelist world. I don't know. I know it's really important to him that I become an amateur radio operator because that's something we can do together, but I'm just not ready. But Robert is also the podcast editor for the company. He'll be editing this episode, just like he edits audio files for many of our clients. Now I'm wondering if he'll catch this part, and that's why I threw it in for fun. But in all seriousness, though, I remember when he decided he wanted to take the initiative and become an amateur radio operator and take that technician test. It wasn't that long ago, maybe a couple of years ago, but he was obsessed. Let me tell you, obsessed with studying. He crammed for a relatively short amount of time, but he was obsessed with it, and he spent any spare moment he had studying. He wanted to achieve his goal. He had delayed for many, many years, but then it became his priority, and he got it done. I'm so proud of him. He passed that technician exam and then contacted an old friend through radio. That friend gently suggested, or maybe it was peer pressure, however you want to call it, that friend of his made the suggestion to take his general, then his extra exams, so that Robert wouldn't be limited on what bandwidth he could talk on. Robert stretched himself, and I continue to see him stretching himself in learning more and more things like that that he loves. He gets frustrated with his projects at times, but more times than I can count, he makes things happen. You see, he doesn't just talk on the radio. There's a lot of challenges and experiments and, you know, electronic doohickeys that he works with. Now, I'm pretty sure that doohickeys is not a term that's on the technician test. So I'm not quite ready to learn all that it takes to pass the test and convert to be a hamvangelist. But he talks about it so much that some of the things are rubbing off on me, and it's scary that I know more than what I let on or I give myself credit for. When the time comes, I tell him if the time comes, but when the time comes and I join his hamvangelist ranks, being around him and hearing the terms is super helpful because that's going to make my studying so much easier. But at the moment, I don't want to stretch myself in that manner. I want to stretch myself in other ways. And I'm excited to stretch myself in a way to create a digital course and build the Scrivener Solutions team to serve more people. And we won't always be in this stretched out mode. No, if you think about it, just like Stretch Armstrong, once you let go, his arms kind of go back into place and he gets his shape back. But in our case, after we're stretched for a little while, we come back to our comfort zone. So we're stretched out of our comfort zone and we're stretched thin and we feel really, really busy, but we're learning something new. We are implementing new processes and we come back to our comfort zone. It will be our new comfort zone, hopefully like a bigger comfort zone because we've experienced new things. Now, when I started Scrivener Solutions, I definitely jumped out of my comfort zone. I was trying new things. I made some mistakes along the way, but that's okay. I learned from them. I challenged myself and I stretched myself. I began learning all that I could about owning a small business. I hit the streets and networked like crazy. I attended seminars about time management and about marketing. I took any and every job I could scrape by with. I wanted anything, even if it wasn't the right fit and it was difficult. I was learning. I felt like I was working all the time and I stretched. I was so stretched in so many different directions. And that made my focus cloudy. But I was making progress, you see. I was learning. I found a new comfort zone, and things got better. And I found this comfort zone, this new comfort zone, by implementing processes, by making the decisions of going with not accepting every single job that would come my way. I learned, and I'm still learning, what to say yes to and what to say no to. Right now, if you are in a job and you want to break away and start your own thing, you will be stretched into doing new things. And you won't really know what you're doing, and that's okay. You will wonder how you'll get everything done. And you will feel behind because you think that you should be able to do everything in such a short amount of time. Don't let that get you down. Feeling stretched and worn thin can last only as long as you let it. We begin to figure out what means the most to us, and we begin to prioritize accordingly. Now remember, you, and only you, are in control over your time and how you use it. You may have a lot going on in your life and in your day or your week, and it may not go exactly how you've planned it. You may have every intention on doing one thing, but then something comes up and you're pulled in a totally different direction. It happens all the time. When you're building a business, you are pulled in a million different directions. What should you do first? You know, that's a hard question to answer. And it's not just business stuff that's on your plate. No, it's the personal stuff too that mounts up. And it's some expected things and some unexpected things. By the way I'm talking, you'd think that I wouldn't have a business with so much freedom. No. Even though I feel stretched to my limits sometimes, I would definitely not go back to a life I had just a few years ago and working in an industry, in a corporation, or in the corporate life that I grew tired of. No matter where we are in life, we will be stretched. Whether it's self-imposed and we are learning something new or doing something new and reaching that goal, or if a situation happens that requires us taking on something totally unexpected, life is full of experiences where we are stretched. But we will come back to our comfort zone. Through our experiences, our comfort zone does get bigger. It's pretty cool. I started my business and developed processes and got back into a comfort zone. Now, you've jumped out of your comfort zone. I know you have. You've stretched yourself only to get back to a new comfort zone. And then there comes a time where you need to stretch yourself again. It became time for me to step up my game and to add a service into my business. I have Scrivener Solutions as a business that I'm running, but I have really stretched myself and am currently developing an online course and community to learn the basics in getting started with your freedom business. And this is truly stretching me. It's like having two jobs. I know that if you are wanting to start something on your own, that it will feel like you have two jobs too. So fitting in another job into an already busy schedule with your day job plus a family, it does pull you to the limit. Even if you've been in business for a while and you are starting something new, you wonder when you'll find time to do it. It's a juggling act for sure, but there will be things that you will let go completely or you'll ask for help with. Now, I gave up my weekly face-to-face networking meetings and replaced my networking with fewer meetings. They're larger educational events that's spattered throughout the year. And also, I am becoming a member of an online mastermind, and we meet less frequently than weekly. Now, I'm taking a course too and networking with other course creators online so that I may streamline my education for this whole process and how to set it up. Now, sure, I can learn all this stuff, this techie stuff, on my own, but it's certainly better to have someone who has already walked that path to simply just tell me what to do. I gladly pay for that guidance and camaraderie with fellow students who have the same struggles that I am in right now, who are stretching like I am. And I certainly don't feel alone. That's why I feel it's so important to create a safe place for the beginner solopreneur. The reason the person that's ready to create their marketing foundation so that they may build their freedom business. But they're not ready to delegate. They need to figure out their processes before they step into delegating those tasks. And it's part of the process. So I gave up much of my face-to-face networking. But then an additional workload came in for my team of virtual assistants. And that grew Scrivener Solutions. Fantastic. I love it. And I am so appreciative of that. In fact, I'd rather be working on my clients' work and help them with their tasks, and that's what excites me. But creating the course to help people who aren't ready to delegate to a VA is super important too. And it takes work. It's like a second job. But since I'm stepping into this new territory for me, I'm stretched. Now, I've worked with clients that have online education platforms, and there's things behind the scenes that I know how to do, but there are so many things when you're doing it yourself that there's a lot of work to that. I know that I must have and make the time in my schedule to do what it takes to get things set up, and there are simply things that I must create and not delegate. There are a lot of things that I have to do. So the process goes slower than what I imagine. And I put pressure on myself and I'm stretched and to pull myself into this new territory. And I'm stretched so much that I don't know what to work on first. Now, I bet I'm not alone in feeling like Stretch Armstrong. When have you felt pulled in so many different directions that you don't know where to start or where your focus should be? Or maybe you've started so many things and haven't gotten around to finishing any of them. Hang in there, my friend. Stretching is good. It's uncomfortable sometimes, but it's good. Good things are about to happen. When you feel stretched to your limit, just take a deep breath. Gain perspective. Be sure to take a bit of time to step back and prioritize what needs to be done. What means the most to you? What bit of stretching will get you closer toward your goal? Make time to make you the priority. If you truly want to achieve your new thing, like what I want to do with launching my digital course, you have to expect to stretch yourself into making the time to learning the new things that you need to and implementing what you have learned, actually doing. It takes discipline and endurance, but you can do it. I'm confident in you. But doing it alone is so much more difficult. There are times where you lose focus. You have doubts in your great ideas. You lose steam, even get frustrated. You're stretching after all. It's a little painful. If you really want to create a business where you have the freedom and scalability to create a lifestyle you want, you surround yourself with those who want to achieve that goal too. You need to surround yourself with those that are talking the same language that you want to learn. Now, I hope I may be your resource for inspiration and motivation for starting and growing your freedom business. A business where you can work from anywhere, you can use online resources to market and grow a business from the skills and experience that you have within you. Now, thanks again for joining me this week. Oh, let's talk a little bit more about stretching. I invite you to join me on my Facebook page as I go live every Friday at 2 p.m. Central. Getting in front of the camera is definitely something that I'm trying to get comfortable with. And honestly, it's painful for me. It's stretching me. But that's okay. I would love for you to be there. Now, a quick link to get there is simply going to GaylaScrivener.com/live. That's Fridays at 2 p.m. Central. You can catch me on Facebook Live. And you can get there by going to Gayla Scrivener, GaylaScrivener.com/live. Now, I hope that you hop in there and say hi. Until next time, have a fantastic week.